Today's video is about self-reflection when you feel stuck in your business. We all go through this, so don't feel like you're alone when you do, but there are some really specific steps that I take myself through personally when I hit a speed bump. And trust me, they are all speed bumps. None of them are complete like journey blockages where you're just never gonna be able to go through. The reason that we go through these speed bumps is because there's something that needs to change within us or within our approach in our business. And the only way that you can do that so that you can move forward, if you sit back, take a moment, and just ask yourself some questions to be able to figure out what it is that you're missing, what you need to tweak, or how you need to, what else you might learn to be able to move forward in your business. So the first thing that I want to ask you is that sometimes it feels really defeating when we're trying to move forward in our business and we keep getting hit with roadblock. Either we're not hitting Success Club consistently, or maybe our coaches just aren't moving forward and owning their business, and it starts to feel defeating and frustrating. But Carl Daikeler once said, if you get 100 no's in this business, does that change your why? And I feel like that's a really awesome blanket statement over anything. Like if you get 100 people to say yes, but then they do nothing and they don't want to go emerald, does that change your why in your business? The answer should be no, right? If you have that deep why that you're really passionate about, if you love this business, if you have something that you're really passionate about working towards, it won't. It won't defeat you. That's your opportunity to just sit down and say, okay, why isn't this working? And what do I need to change? The next thing you need to do is just get really curious. That's another, I think Carl Daikeler mentioned a book called Curious. I'll have to look that up, but sit down and study what's going wrong in your business and break it into pieces. What's working for you? Because it can't all be going wrong, right? There's something that I'm sure you're doing in there, right? But what isn't working? What is it that you can just slightly change your approach or tweak? Sometimes the biggest momentum growth periods in my business aren't from me just completely radically changing how I work my business. It's making just a couple small minor tweaks that were creating some kind of blockage in my business before. That might be your approach and how you're leading your team. It might be your social media. It might be Facebook ads. It might be what your systems are for getting your new coaches started right. It might be how you're managing your time. So sit down and ask yourself, like, where are the blocks? What am I doing well? What is working? So don't go change everything. If it's working, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? And figure out where you need to make some small tweaks. Next is, and this is the last thing that you're going to want to do after you sit down and do some serious self-reflection about what you're doing. I often see people, the first thing that they go do is go pick other people's brain. The first thing you need to do is pick your own brain, because usually you're going to find your answer within yourself. And then if you can't or you need some inspiration, go ask some other leaders what they're doing. But remember, if you're just constantly asking questions from other people, what that kind of silently says about you is that you don't believe in your own ability to solve this problem. You have it in you, I promise you. Sometimes you might need a small perspective switch, but most likely you're going to be able to find the answer on your own. So maybe doing a little bit of Googling, maybe studying people completely outside our industry. I do that often. I'll study people who are in the marketing world online, and they run their businesses online, like Marie Forleo or Brené Bouchard, and I study how they're working their business and the people that follow them, and I figure, how can I apply that to network marketing? So I get curious, and I silently become a student, not to compare, but just to learn. And oftentimes we need to do this really very humble ego check. Because sometimes it feels to us like we're doing everything right. I used to tell myself that. I'm doing all the things that I'm supposed to be doing. There must be some secret. And the reality is that my ego was like too big to be able to say this, that I'm stuck because of me. And in the reality, you are where you deserve to be. I am where I deserve to be based off of how I've approached my business, based off my self-reflection, based off of my willingness to learn and to study and to reapproach. Because if it's not working, it's because I'm doing something wrong, either in my leadership style or, and now that's not to say with leadership, by the way, some people just don't want it. And so if none of your coaches are, let's say you have 100 personally sponsored coaches and none of them are hitting the Success Club, there's definitely somewhere in there where you need to look at what you're doing and how you're approaching this business. But if you have maybe like 20% of your people are working, that's pretty average. So, but it's really important to recognize and realize I'm not a victim. I am exactly where I deserve to be in my business. And the only way I'm going to move forward is to figure out where the cracks are and how I can fill them. There's always going to be cracks. We're always good. Like naturally, we just want to grow. That's one of the basic human needs is for growth. And so it doesn't matter how far in this business you get, if you're a 15-star diamond, a triple 15-star diamond, we all have this deep need to grow and to get better. There's always going to be cracks in our foundation. So a real true leader, the first thing that they'll ask themselves is not what is everybody else doing wrong, but what am I doing wrong? The next question that I have for you is, are you blocking yourself, maybe even subconsciously? What are your core beliefs about yourself? So sometimes I know that I had this belief about myself that I'm good, but I'll never be great. And I don't know where that belief came from yet, but it's something that I'm really working on. I'm doing a lot of journaling. I'm doing a lot of meditation. Sometimes just going for a walk will really help you. Sometimes just sitting in silence, like maybe meditation isn't your thing, but just sit there in silence. Don't let no music. Sometimes I'll go for a drive and I won't turn the music on and I'll just be with my thoughts. And it's amazing what stuff starts to pop out and having these ahas. I love personal development to inspire ideas as far as like personal blockages up here mentally. The Big Leap is a book that's been a game changer for me. Anything that has to do with mindset. I love Wayne Dyer stuff. He's a little bit more spiritual, but Gabrielle Bernstein is amazing. But I know like most of the time when my business isn't moving forward, it's because I have some core belief and I'm self-sabotaging and not even realizing it. That happens in our health and fitness. It happens in our business. It happens in our relationships. It happens in our money. So figuring out where that self-sabotaging behavior is coming from and where that core belief is about what you deserve is really, really important. The other thing that you can do is ask a friend for constructive criticism, but don't get defensive. You have to willingly open yourself up to be criticized, and it's hard and it is uncomfortable, but growth happens when you're uncomfortable. It's the same way a muscle grows, right? We have to tear that muscle down before we can build it up even stronger. Same way mentally, the way that we have to be able to kind of check our ego at the door, be willing to take some hard constructive criticism, realize we've done stuff wrong. Our ego is meant to protect us sometimes, but it can be a nasty beast that keeps us from moving forward as well. And then other little things that I've done for myself are create daily mantras for myself. And sometimes I will save those in my phone as calendar alerts where it will pop up consistently every day of the week that says you're a finisher. Or something like that, because I have this habit of starting projects and not finishing, or you are disciplined, or you're a good leader, or you're a great leader. I need to stop using the word good about myself, because that is like a belief that I've used to hold myself back. Like, oh, I'm good enough. And that's how I approach my life. I do things in my life. I approach my fitness. I approach the way that I like keep my house tidy. Oh, it's good enough. Like, not to say we have to be perfect in every area, but that's a mindset block for me. And so me watching the words that I use on myself, the words that you speak and think about yourself have this really, really strong connection and will create your reality very literally. So be careful about the words. I was on a coaching call with Rachel Luna today and I said to her, I'm a really great giver. I'm a horrible receiver. And she said immediately, don't ever say that about yourself again. That was that. And I was like, oh, crap. I realized like, wow, I'm projecting that and continuing to create and cement that belief about myself. So those are my tips for you guys on how I use self-reflection to be able to get past those tough growth periods in our business, but I promise you, as uncomfortable as it feels, it's such a relief when you finally bust through that plateau and you gain that momentum in your business. So it's all worth it.